As myself, Pooja Verma, going to take my lecture on subject concept of programming language C. As in the previous lecture, we already completed our number of operators in C, and now I'm going to discuss about the decision tree statements. How we can use those operators which we already covered in using decision making statements. What is the decision making statements? Basically, the decision making statements require that the programmer specify one or more conditions to be evaluated or tested by programs. Along with this, a statement or statements to be executed if the condition is true, and also we can mention various actions when the condition is false. With the help of flowchart, I am going to explain the working of a decision making statements. Like here, some condition is given here. In this box, I just mentioned the conditions, and if the condition is true, then what we did? We did the conditional codes. And if the condition is false, here we nothing perform any additional operation. We just go to the rest of program part and then stop. This is a simple flowchart of simple if statement, not if else, only if. That means what? According to the true condition, only the condition case is given, not any false conditional code is given here. Okay, so this is a basic flowchart of if statement. And if statement is known as the basic decision making statement also. Further, we go in deep about what is the if statements. So now we can see that if statement consists of a boolean expressions followed by one or more statements, and this is a syntax of if statements. That means when in our program the condition is mentioned about only true part, that means when the condition is true, then we need to perform this. When the condition is false, we don't need to perform anything. Okay, then you use only if statements. So what is the expression of this? This is the expression. By this expression box, we can write our code in our program. Like if, then your expressions, whatever you want to perform, what either using logical operators, conditional operators, relational operators, and so on. This is totally depends on our program, questions and tasks, and so on. And this is the scope area of if, and where we can mention the statements. We mentions the statements that will be executed about help of true condition of this statement. This is the mandatory. Don't we think here we can write anything? No, we can't write anything. We can write only those statements which will be performed after this statement is read as the value as true value. Okay, now the working of this we can see with the help of simple flowchart again. That condition, if condition is given, then we go through the if code. That means if is scope area, and when the condition is false, we don't perform anything, just follow the next part of the if code. Okay, and then we just see a simple question where we just perform where the task is given, like check the given number is less than 20 or not. Okay, so what is the given here? Just check the number is less than 20 or not. That means if the given number is less than 20, then just show the output. That means A is less than 20. If a number is never less than 20, that means number is not less than 20, that means value is equal to less than 20 is false, then what we did? We don't did anything here, because in our task only mentions show output when the A value of A is less than 20. ओके, तो व्हाट इज द टास्क, ओनली प्रिंट द आउटपुट व्हेन द वैल्यू इज लेस देन 20. हियर नन इंस्ट्रक्शंस इज गिवन टू अस अबाउट व्हेन द वैल्यू इज फॉल्स. ओके, सो जस्ट सी हियर, एज पर डिस्कस इन द लास्ट लेक्चर आई टोल्ड यू दैट फर्स्ट वी नीड टू एड द प्री प्रोसेसर डायरेक्टिव्स and include the various header files. Okay, so here I am using has include studio.h, has include kunu.h, and then again here I don't feel that there are some global variable is being used, so I go through only the main function. Now main function is what? I use the main function of type void, and then scope area of main function is this. Here, in this question, I already take the value of a equal to 10. And now I am going to check my conditions. What is the condition? If the value of a is less than 20, then we need to print. What we need to print? I print the value is a less than 20. You can also take the value of a from the user, like by giving the instructions printf, enter the number and then scanf. Okay, so by using that method you can also give the instructions to the user to give the input value randomly. But here in this question I am just initialize my value of a which is equal to 10. Okay, so this is only check, this condition is only check for a equal to 10, not so many times we can check here. So again, we just perform the if, and then rest of program is what? Print the value of a. That means what is the exactly value of a by which we print this? A is less than 20. Because the right now, with the help of this printer functions, on the screen, we just see the message a is less than 20. But what is the exactly the value of a? So I also print a new printer function with the message of value of a is percentile d and then comma a. So what is the happening here? At the place of percentile d, the value of a is inherited and then print here. So output will be value of a is, and then whatever the value is will be printed. Okay, so according to the first printf call, a is less than 20 and then value of a is 10 according to the rest of program part. Okay, so we perform anything if the a is not less than 20? No. Here none kind of the else situation is given. So let's suppose if here I give the a equal to 30. So what is the output? The output is only value of a is 30. Okay. Why? Because when we go through the if part, a less than 20, then we get the value of each if is false. And according to the false condition, don't perform to anything here. Just look at your flowchart. Whenever we get the value of condition is false, just perform the rest of program and then stop. So where we go? We go just out of this scope area. So out of this scope area, that means here. So here when we go, then we find the next line printf. So only this line will be printed when the a condition is not satisfy the given conditions. Okay, so now check again I am taking another example with the help of this. Maybe our concept will be clear about the if. Okay, so just check it here. What is the task? Write a program in C to accept the radius from the users. Okay, if the radius is greater than 3, then calculate the area of circle and print it. So just read it and find out. Either here in this questions I asked about the value about the less than 30. What you need to perform when the value is less than 30? No, here nothing is mentioned here about the value is less than 30. Here mentions about only if the value is greater than 30, then you just calculate the circle and print it. If the value is not less than 30, then you don't need to perform anything. You can just go through the rest of part and then print. Okay, so this is the most important part. I mention here That means what is the condition I found according to the question. So I found if the radius is greater than 3, then we need to calculate the area of, and then another thing to do. Okay, so I am writing my program. Has included std.h for the input output functions, has included kun.h for the console input output functions, then wide main for the main functions starting, and then here I am just taking the variables integer type of radius, like just you can take also in the form of float also. Don't we think that radius value will be only in integer form, it will be in form of float also. I am just taking here in form of integer only. Okay, and then area is in form of float. Why? Because the A formula of area is what? The formula of area is pi r square, and according to that the value will be must become in the float type, because the pi value is 3.14. okay, so always and always whenever either we give the value of radius is equal to an integer or float, the area will be always come in form of float. Okay, so for that only I am just taking the two variables for storing the radius to check the conditions and calculate the area and store in this area variables for calling the value. Now here I am not defined the radius before. Here the user can give the value. So according to the question also we can check the accept the radius from the user. Whenever the mention in your question accept the radius from the user, then just think always must be clear that we need to print and this scanf line. We need to perform the print to check for that portion, like enter the radius and then perform the scanf to store that value, whatever the given by the user, into the radius variable. So according to the variables, I perform the radius. So here whatever the user print in form of integer only, it will be stored in the location ampersand radius. That means in the memory location, the value will be stored into the radius. Now I am going, as I store the value of radius into the variable radius, so now I am going to check the variable's value is less than equal to 3 or not. If the value of radius is less than equal to 3, then we just print a message, the radius is less than or equal to 3, so we can perform anything or not. So I am again going to my questions, like what is the question? The radius is greater than 3. So what is our question here? Here I just check the radius is less than 3 or not. Less than equal, if the value is less than equal to 3, so what we need to perform? We don't perform anything. We don't perform anything. Here I am just taking a condition, but if you don't perform this, then also your question is correct. Okay, because according to the question, only this will be the performed by the programmer. You can also perform this for the enhancement or for the betterment of the your program only, not anything else, for the logically, for the understanding of another user about your program, that exactly what are you doing in this program. So I am going to the check according to the my question, the radius value is greater than 3 or not. If the value is greater than 3, then perform the, then we need to calculate the area. Area is equal to 3.14 multiply by radius and multiply by radius. That means what? Pi r square. Okay, so now I need to print that area also according to the our questions. You need to print your area. So I am just perform the print, call the print functions. Area of circle with the radius percentile d. With the radius percentile d means what? Right now here which value is printed? Here two format specifier is mentions. First is percentile d and each then percentile 0.2f. And now just check it again. The order of the calling of variable is radius and area. That means first format specifier is mentions for the only for the radius. Yes, this is correct because radius is type of integer and this is also type of integer. Okay, and then each percentile 0.2f. So what is the format specifier? Which type of format specifier? This is a type of float. And also we can check that second variable is area. That means whatever the value is calculated here, this will be stored in our memory and we can call with the help of printf function like this. So what is the exactly output of this program? We can check here. Enter the radius. According to the first printf line, 3 will be printed. Like I am going to give the value 3. So what is the answer? According to our question, for the 3 value we need to perform to calculate our area. No, whenever the value is greater than 3, then we can only perform the area. Here I am just taking the one example, like if the radius is equal to 3, then we just show the message like your radius is less than or equal to 3, not greater than 3, so we can't perform the calculation over the area. So let's take another example also. And then in this example, the user asks that write a program in C to check whether the number is divisible by 5 or 17. Here again we check that here only give the value is greater than, is divisible by 5 or 70 or not. Only just you need to check whether the number is divisible, not about given anything about not. When the number is divisible by not and so on, nothing else. That means nothing else part is given. Nothing is given about the your action about when the condition is false. So what we perform here? We need to just check the number is divisible by 5 or 17 is okay or not. So first we need to check, we need to take value number in form of number from the user. Okay, so that means what? According to our question, we decided that there are variables we need to take in form of integer and then divide our integer by 5 or by 17 and check this value is divisible by 5 or 17 or not. So what is the meaning of divisible? The meaning of divisible means what? Whenever the number is divided by 5, the remainder will be equal to 0. So when we find that whenever we divide any value by any number and remainder will be the 0, so we check our operators and we find out what? We have a remainder function also which perform this action. That means checking the value divided by any variables and check whether the remainder is equal to 0 or not. So that means we need to check we perform our questions like in this form also. If the number is divisible by 5, that means number divide percentile 5 means is, that means the meaning of this statement expression is the number is divisible by 5 or not. That means remainder of number when divided by 5. Then we need to what check? We need to check the remainder of number divided by 5 is equal to 0 or not. If this is value is equal to 0, then that means our condition is true. Or why I mentioned the or operator here? Because in this questions, this is mentions 5 or 17, not both. That means we need to check a number either divisible by 5 or divisible by 17 also. That means if the number is 10, then 10 is also here considered. Why? 10 is divided by 5. But 10 is divided by 17? No, 10 is not divided by 17. So don't be confused that here I am asking about and or. Here in this question mentions or. That means either it is divisible by 5 or it is divisible by 17. That means the number must be divisible by any one number, either 5 or 17. Not necessary it divisible by both. Okay. So similarly, we also perform to check the number is divisible by 17 or not. Here by mistake I write the 7 here, but here in this question this is value is 17. Okay, so I am going to write my program has include std.h, has include kuni.h according to the preprocessor directives, and then now I am going to my main function. Then I just here take one variables like number to store the number from the taking from the users, and then clear the screen. Only for the clear the screen we use the CLR, SCR functions, and now I am going to give the instructions to the user, enter a number and then to call that number, scan that number into the number variables which is already declared here, and provide a memory location by which the value entered by the user here is stored in the memory locations. And now I am going to check on that number, whatever the written by the user, is divisible by 5 or 17 or not. So I just type my condition, if the number is divisible by 5 or number divisible by 17. I just print the number is divisible by 5 or 17. That means I just show the message, number is divisible by 5 or 17. Okay, only this. Here I am not going to perform anything in the else part, because this question is basically a type of if statement. Okay, if you want to go through, perform anything message, want to show any message about the else part also, that this the given number, the number given by you is not divisible by 5 or 17, then you can mention your else part here. By mistakely the next page will be missing here, so don't worry, maybe it will be in next to next page. Just check it. Here also this question is given. Actually this question is type of printf, if and else part. Okay, using if and else. If number is divisible by 5 or 7, then you can print it. If number is not 5 by 7, then in mention you can mention this in else part, number is not divisible by 5 or 17. So don't worry, you can also perform this question by 5 if also, don't need to perform anything else. Okay, so now I am going to the next type of boolean expression, next type of conditional statement, which is known as the if else statements. The requirement, the drawback of if statement is what? User can give the line as an output only the condition is true. Nothing about the condition is false. That means maybe someone confused about what is the exactly happened here by which we can't get our output. So we need to here show a message about the false condition also. For that, the user can easily understand about whatever you want to ask me about the true conditions and whatever you given to me about the false conditions. So I am just here performing. If your condition is matched, then we go through this. If your condition is not matched, then we go through that part only. Okay, so now the if and else statement is used for giving the both conditional statement. We mention also the if, and when the condition is false, then we go through the else part. Don't be confused that if and else part both are performing at the same time. Never. Either we go through the if condition, either we go through the else statement. That means what? Either we can check, either we can go through the true part or false part. At the same time, nothing is possibility about the true and false both here. Okay, either our condition is true, either our condition is false. So please clear it. That means no, not both are performing at the same time. Only one condition is true. Only one conditional statement is performed, either if part, either else part. Okay, so this is the syntax. If our condition, then we go through perform the statements will be executed here only if expression is true. Else, then statements will executed of the boolean expression when the condition is false, only that statements. So what is the flow chart? Just look at here. Start, then conditions, then false, then condition is true, then we go through the if code, whatever we written into the first scope area, this is scope area, we go through the this part. If our condition is false, then we go through the else code, else scope area, and then go through the rest of program and stop. So just take a basic example of if and else, which is the most famous example, if and else decision making statement. Write a program in C to accept a number from the user and print whether the number is odd or even. That means what? We need to check the number is given is odd or even. That means both. We need to check either the condition is, either the number is even, either the number is false. So what we find? We find that here the both situation is given. If code and else code is also given. So first we need to again decide about the logic. What is the logic? Whenever the number is even, the number is even when the given number is fully divided by 2. So what is the meaning of fully divided by 2? That means When we perform the division of number by 2, then the remainder of value is equal to 0. Again, whenever I just think that remainder will be equal to 0, that means what? In our C language, there are operator is also mentioned again. The number is divided by percentile 2. That means what? This statement again gives us the information about the remainder when the number is divided by 2. The remainder of that action. Then remainder of that action is equal to 0 or not. If this value is 0, then the number is even. If this number is not equal to 0, that means remainder is not equal to 0, then the number is odd. And then we go through the stop part. So again here I also mentioned why use the percentile. Generally we said the number is divided by 2 successfully is even, but mathematically it is meaning that when a number is divided by 2 and the remainder is 0, then the even only. Okay, so that we use only the remainder operators here. I also mentioned this concept here. So go through the programming code. Programming code is what? Again we need to declare a variable like number, either you can write the n and anything, whatever you want. This is totally depends on you, in which form you want to your variable's name and so on. So you can just take here. Okay, then go through the CLR, SCR, then printf function, enter the number and take the value from the user and store the location here. By mention this part, we can provide the locations about the number to so save that value into the memory locations. And now I am going to check my number is divisible by 2 or not. If the number is divisible by 2, then we just call a printf functions about your number, whatever you given here is even. Okay, and also we can perform else part. So don't be think that here I need to mention the number of divisible by 2 is not equal to 0. No, whatever we written here in the else part in the C programming language, automatically it takes that this condition is false. That means the number divisible by 2 is not equal to 0. Okay, so don't be think we need to write here this code part, this condition part. No, automatically in the case of if and else, this is a predefined keywords, and here the meaning of else is predefined that whatever the conditions is checked into the if conditions, the exact opposite of perform in this else part. Okay, so here in this program code we don't mention any conditions about else. Automatically our computer can understand this condition is false. This condition is false means what? The number divided by 2 is not equal to 0. So we need to go a call of print function that the number is given by you is odd number. Okay, just have a look on the output. Like first when I'm going to check my questions, the enter the number, I just enter the 30. So what the output I get? If the condition is divided by 2, 30 is divisible by 2, yes, the remainder will be 0. So what printf function is called here? Is this part or this part? This part only, because this condition is true. So we go through only this printf function. Don't we think we go through this part only? No, we have either this condition or this line will be printed. Not both lines will be printed at the same time in the if and else. No, always only one condition is true, either this, either this. So only go through only one action, either this action or this action. So now according to the number, the given number, whatever the number is even. So let's have a look on our output. Yes, the number, the given number is equal to 30 is even. Just check another time in your program and check a number which is not divisible by 2. So I enter the number is 15. So this number is divisible by 2 or not? Not. So according to the else conditions, the number is whatever you enter is odd. Okay, so this is a program code. Again I am going to show you, and please type this program in your system and then just check it, is this correct or not, and enter the various numbers randomly and check this program code is true or not. Okay. You note it. Now, also I am going to again explain the question is divisible by 5 or 7 and I whatever the here I need to perform. If the number is divisible by 5 or 7, then just show the message. Yes, your number, whatever the number given by the user is divisible by 5 or 17. And if it is not, then we just perform that show a message. The number you enter is not divisible by 5 or 17. So here the information is just regarding the number whatever you enter is divisible by 5 or 17 or not. So in this lecture first I'm going to now summarize whatever we learned in this lecture. First I explained about the simple decision making statement, that is if statements. That means what? When only we need to perform the actions about the true condition, then we just only call the if statements here only. Okay, and when we realize that no, I need also to show some message about the false situations also, so I go through the another decisions making a statement that is known as the if else statements. Like I perform a questions about the even or not, that means number is divisible by 2, then 2, then even. If it is not true, that is false. Else part, then we go through the odd also. Okay, so this is the most important point, and again I am only point out you that if the whenever you perform your questions, don't be confused about the both printf function is called by your computer. No, whenever we compile our program, the compiler go through the if part. If this condition is true, then it just go through only this area. Whenever it read here, whenever it reached here, what is action perform here? Don't think that is whenever this perform is here, then it go through the else part. No, according to the pre functions definitions of, wait a minute, definition of this if statement in the C, it is decided that whenever this action is performed fully, when you go this part, that means closing curly braces, then you just go through the rest part of the program. Never ever go through the S part. This is automatically predefined in our programming concept. As I already told you that there are several things is predefined. So the meaning of if and the meaning of else is predefined here. Like when the condition is false, then that means here already predefined that whenever you got the value is false, then you just go through the else. That means you just enter into the else scope area. So I am right now my compiler is go through the this scope area. So this only this part is printed, nothing print here, because when this the compiler show that the condition value is false. So according to the predefinition, what it get? If this value is false, then just go to the else scope area. So I am going to the else program code only. So just check. Don't think that means I saw here two things, so both are at perform at the same time. No, this is output one. When I perform first time, compile our program and run our program, then I just give the value 34 and get the answer. The number is divisible by 5 or 17. Yes, because the number is divisible by 17. 34 is divisible by 17. And again, when I am going through the compile my program to check another number for this program code, I just enter the value 38. So I am going to check the number of 38 is divisible by 5. No, this value is not divisible by 5. Is this divisible by 17? No. So what is the exact value here? So exactly here we go through the else part. That means the number is not divisible by 5 or 17. So just check it here also. So here I also show an message about the number is not divisible by 5 or 17. So hope you have a better clarification about the what kind of the action we need to perform in if part, what kind of the action and how the compiler can execute if part code, and whenever the compiler go through the else program part code. Okay, so if you have any questions, then you can ask me anytime. And again I'm going to tell you that please perform this program code in your software and check the in the C programming language, you must be have a practice more and more for the better clarification about the programming logic. Okay, so thank you class. In this lecture, we only just read about the if and if else, and again in the next lecture, we can go through the several if and else part, nested if and else, ladder if and else, and so on. Okay, so thank you. Have a good day.